morning, everyone. Hello, guests. Hi, Ayu. Are you joining me today? Hi, Phyllis. Good to see all of you. Good morning, JP. It's a nice and kind of like a lazy, cozy, rainy morning to start a Monday. So I think a yin yang class is good. Hi, Patty. Yes, nice to have all of you this morning. Welcome to Yin Yang class. My name is Jeannie. I'm here to guide you through your practice this morning. Hello, Masako. Alright, so for Yin Yang class, for those who have not joined this class before, let me kind of just explain to you what this class is. Basically, for Yin Yang class, we start off with the Yang part. So for the Yang part, it's a more active poses. Expect some flow, so I'll be flowing through some sun salutations to kind of warm up the body. Today, we'll work a little bit more on maybe inner thighs, the hips, and maybe a little bit of the counter stretch to stretch out the outer part of the legs, the IT bands as well. So if you have some props, I'm going to tell you what we need for today. If you have some kind of a pillow, if you have a block, that'll be good. If you don't have a block, it doesn't matter. Just maybe something high. So perhaps a bolster, pillows or something like that. All right. So whatever that you have, if not, we can also work with the body. I'll be giving you options to see what props you have, alright? Hi Fong, hi Genevieve, welcome to Yin Yang class. Alright, thank you for joining me this morning. Like I mentioned, it's kind of like a cool Monday morning, alright? Okay, can all of you hear me loud and clear? I think for now you can. If I move back further, just kind of a check before we start. Can you guys hear me loud and clear if I'm from here? If yes, give me a thumbs up. So just want to check that everything is okay before we start the class. All right, thank you very much. And kind of a disclaimer first, my hips is not very good today. So at some point in time, if I need to stop, I'll continue to guide the class. So don't worry, I can still flow through. It's just that I might walk a little bit funny. All right. All of you guys ready to start the class? Yes. Alright, cool. Let's come to a comfortable seat on your mat. Now find a seat on the mat. Cross your legs. Place the hands on the knees and start to sit up nice and tall. Keep the spine lengthened. Close your eyes. See, you can deepen your breath in and out through the nose. Start to find stillness. With each inhalation, sit up a little bit taller to lengthen the spine. And as you exhale, expel out all the still air. And start to work inwards, emptying out your mind. Clearing the mind of thoughts of things from last week, the weekend. So you can create space. Letting go of your thoughts. And start to arrive on the mat for your practice. Dedicate the next 60 minutes to you, solely to you and your practice. Keeping this sense of peace and stillness to guide you through the practice. As you stay focused, your deep breath, start to turn on your Ujjayi breath. That means you constrict the back of the throat. Continue to breathe in and out deeply through the nose, hearing your breath more clearly, sounding like ocean waves. Let this breath guide you through the practice. Join your palms together, thumbs to the heart center. Now if you'd like to set an intention before we begin, go ahead. Perhaps think about something that can kickstart this week. that'll keep you focused, give you strength, and allow it together with the breath to guide you through your practice this morning. Bring your thumbs to the eyebrow center, gently bow forward. Wake your eyes open, namaste everyone. Enjoy your practice. Now let's find your all fours, come to your tabletop. Spread the fingers out wide, stack the shoulders on top of the wrists, hips on top of the knees and feet hip distance apart. We'll begin with cat-cow breathing to warm up the spine. As we inhale, belly down, tailbone up, chin up, gaze up to the ceiling, arching into your cow pose. Exhale to tuck the chin to the chest, look to the belly button, protract the shoulders, round the back, push into the palms. Inhale to melt the heart, moving with the breath, shoulders away from the ears, gaze up, tailbone up. Exhale to scoop the sit bone under, draw the navel into the spine, push into the palm, more round the back. Three more times, inhale. Exhale. Inhale, arching the spine, cow pose, look up. Exhale to a cat pose, protract the shoulders, spread the shoulder blades apart. One more time, inhale, melt the heart, rolling the shoulders back and down, look up to the ceiling, arch the spine. Exhale, tuck the chin to the chest, look to the belly button, round the back, push into the palms. Back to a neutral spine. Now tuck the toes, lift the knees, come to your first downward facing dog. Hips up, heels down, spread the fingers out wide. Now keep the feet hip distance apart. Then if you like, you can bend the knees one by one. Your first down dog, start to stretch out the body, do what you like. Open the back of the body. First, if you like to focus on the hamstrings, you can bend the knees one by one, grounding the heels down alternatively. Start to open the back of the legs. Notice how the hamstrings are feeling. If they are more open by now, so you can squeeze on top of the kneecap nice and tight. Push the thighs back, straighten the legs, ground the heels down, stretch it out. Spread the fingers out wide, push the top of the mat away from you. Send the sit bone high up to the ceiling as you bring the belly closer to the thighs, forehead closer to the mat. Stay here for one more deep breath, inhale. Push into the palms, ground the heels down further with your exhale. Feet hip distance apart. Now heels up high, inhale. Bend the knees as exhale, belly to the thighs. Stay pushing the top of the mat away from you. Give the back a good stretch. Think of melting the chest closer to touch the thighs. One more deep breath in. Look forward, plank, inhale, shift the weight forward. Squeeze the kneecap nice and tight. Now hips align the shoulders, protract the shoulders. Push round the back slightly like cat's spine. One more deep breath, inhale. Press back, downward facing dog, exhale. Feet together, feet hip distance, sorry, heels up high, inhale. Drop the heels to the right as exhale. Now stay, body stays twisting. Then bend the knees, push the top of the mat away from you. Bring the belly closer to touch your thighs. Twist the body, push into the left palm, stretch the left side of the body. One more deep breath. Straighten the legs, heels up high, back to the center, inhale. Drop your heels to the left side. Then bend the knees, bring the belly to the thighs. Now you should feel the right side body stretch. Push a little bit more into right hand. Bring the belly closer to the thighs, but keep the sit bone up high. One more deep breath here. Straighten the legs back to the center, heels up high, inhale. Now bend the knees, exhale, belly to the thighs. Stretch out the back one more time, one more deep breath. Look forward, plank, inhale, shift the weight forward. Stack shoulders on top of the wrist, draw the belly in. As I exhale, knees, chest, chin down, in point pose. So place the chest between the thumbs, hug the elbows in, keep the hips out high, look forward. Untap the toes, now glide forward, find a full cobra. So straight arms, roll the shoulders back, just push lightly into the hands, lift the chest forward, look up to the ceiling, arch the spine. Tap the toes, exhale, press back, down with facing dog. One breath in, full breath out. Feet together, heels
heels up high. Now look forward, step a hop lightly forward. Come to the top of the mat. Half lift, lengthen the spine. You can place your hands on the shins or fingertips down to the mat. Inhale. Exhale to fold over the thighs. Inhale the standing, rise up, palms touch. Lean back, arch bend to a gentle back bend. Exhale to bow forward all the way down, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine, heel. Exhale to fold. Inhale to rise, palms touch, lean back, arch back. So you can deepen the back bend, open the front, lift the chest, arms and legs straight. Exhale to bow forward all the way down, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine, heel. Exhale to fold. One more time, inhale to rise, palms touch, lean back, arch back, chest up. So you can bring the arms behind the ears, keep the chest up. Hips forward, stomach forward. One more deep breath, inhale. Hands in front of the chest, Samasthiti. Come to the top of the mat if you're not already there. Place your feet together, bring the palms together. We'll blow through our sun salutation. Inhale, reach arms up, lean back, arch back. Exhale, bow forward all the way down, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine, heel. Exhale to fold, step the right leg back. Lower the right knee down, low lunge. Anjaneyasana, stretch your arms up, inhale, reach up, lean back. Now bend the left knee, sink the hips down low. Stay here for a moment, stretch your arms back. Deepen the back bend, chest up. One more deep breath, inhale. Hands down, now step back to your downward facing dog. Exhale. Plank, inhale, shift the weight forward. Knees, chest, chin down, in point pose, exhale. Untuck the toes, glide forward to your full cobra, roll the shoulders back, gaze up. Tuck the toes, exhale to press back, downward facing dog, one breath in, full breath out. Feet together, heels up high, stretch your right leg up, three-legged dog, inhale. Knee to the nose, exhale to touch and hold, 3, 2, 1. Step right foot between the hands, lower the left knee down, stretch your arms up, inhale, sink the hips down low, reach up, lean back. So you can deepen the back bend, keep the chest up high, reach your arms back more, hold it for one more deep breath, inhale. Hands down, step the left foot forward, forward fold, Uttanasana, exhale. Inhale to standing, rise up, palms touch, lean back, arch back. Exhale, bow forward, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine, heel. Exhale, fold, step left leg back. Lower the left knee down, low lunge. Anjaneyasana, stretch your arms up. Reach up, lean back. Stay here, same thing, bend the right knee, sink the hips down low. Feel the left hip flexor open, stretch your arms up and back. One more deep breath, heel. Hands down, step back to your downward facing dog. Exhale. Plank, inhale, knees, chest, chin down, exhale. Untuck the toes, full cobra, inhale, straighten the arms, shoulders roll back, gaze up. Tuck the toes, exhale, press back, down, one facing dog, one breath in. Full breath out. Feet together, heels up high, left leg stretch up, three little dog, inhale. Knee to the nose, exhale, touch, shift the weight forward, hold it, 3, 2, 1. Step left foot forward, lower the right knee down, stretch your arms up high, heel, reach up, lean back. Anjaneyasana, your low lunge. Straighten the arms, look up to the ceiling, chest up and lean back. One more breath, inhale. Hands down, step the right foot forward fold, Uttanasana, exhale. Inhale to rise, all the way up, palms touch. Lean back, arch back, back bend. Hands in front of the chest, Samasthiti, one breath in. Full breath out. Inhale to reach arms up, lean back, arch back. Exhale, bow forward all the way down, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine, heel. Exhale, fold, step the right leg back. Lower the right knee down, low lunge, Anjaneyasana, stretch your arms up, inhale, look forward. Now open the chest towards the right side, stretch your left hand forward, right hand back. Reverse right hand to the back leg, sweep left bicep by the ear, lean back, arch back. Bend the left knee, stretch your left hand back. One more breath, inhale. As you exhale, place left hand inside the left foot. Inhale to sweep the right bicep by the ear. Exhale to roll the right shoulder back. Chest lift, roll the right shoulder back more. One more deep breath. Back to your low lunge. Inhale, stretch your arms up. Now this time, hook the thumbs, spread the fingers out wide like this. And squeeze the bicep to the ears, lean back, arch back. So you can move the arms back behind the ears, deepening the back bend. Chest lift, reach up. One more deep breath, inhale. Hands down, now kick the left leg up to your three-legged dog. Point the left toes up to the ceiling, reach up high as inhale. Knee to the left tricep, pull it up high, exhale to touch. Inhale, kick the left leg up, three-legged dog. Knee to the nose, exhale, shift the weight forward to touch. Inhale, kick the left leg up, three-legged dog. Knee to the right tricep, pull it up high to touch and hold, three, two, one, straighten the left leg out to the right, spin the inner right foot down, reverse side plank. Push down, lift the hips up high. Then sweep the right bicep by the ear, option to stay here or find your inner thigh strength so you can drag the left foot towards you and float it up. Push down, hips up high. One more deep breath, inhale. Right hand down, kick the left leg up. Bend the left knee, open the hips as exhale. Straighten the left leg, inhale. Downward facing dog, exhale. Plank, inhale. Your choice of vinyasa, chaturanga, or knees, chest, shin, exhale. Inhale to up dog or cobra. Exhale to press back. Downward facing dog, one breath in. Full breath out. Feet together, heels up high. Stretch your right leg up to the ceiling, three-legged dog, inhale. Knee to the nose, exhale, shift the weight forward to touch. Inhale to kick the right leg up, bend the right knee, open the hips as exhale. Now you can stay here or flip into your morphing. Land the ball of the right foot behind you, keep the chest up high, reach the right bicep by the ear. So you can touch your fingertips down to the ground. Hold it here, one more deep breath. Right hand down, kick the right leg up, bend the right knee, open the hips as exhale. Left heel up high, heel. Knee to the nose, exhale, hold it here for 3, 2, 1. Crescent lunge, step the right foot forward, inhale to rise. Bend the right knee, sit the hips down low. Now set up a crescent lunge properly first. Keep the left heel up high. Bend the right knee, sit down a little bit lower. Stretch your arms up high, inhale. Now open up to your warrior two, exhale. Spin the left heel down, bend the right knee, spread the arms apart, right hand forward, left hand back. Look towards the right hand, lean forward with the right palm in heel. Reverse warrior, exhale. Left hand to the back leg, sweep right bicep by the ear, lean back, arch back, stretch back further for one more deep breath. Back to your warrior two, inhale, supported side anchor, exhale. Place right elbow on top right thigh, sweep the left bicep by the ear, inhale. Lean back, open the chest, exhale. Option to stay here or place the right fingertips inside the right foot. Come to extended side ankle pose. Continue to lean the left shoulder back. Hold it here. Back to your warrior two, inhale. Now straighten the right leg. Walk the left foot in one step. Lean forward, Trikonasana, right hand down on the shin. Our right fingertips place outside the right foot, it can go deeper. But the energy lifts up, so stretch left hand out. Hold it here. Sweep the left bicep by the ear if you like. Lean back further. One more deep breath. As you exhale, place left hand on the left hip. Find half moon pose. Crawl the right fingertips forward a little bit more. And slowly float the left leg up. Use the left hand to peel the left hip open, so the left toes point towards the left side of the room. Once you're ready, extend the left hand up and see if you can lift the left leg up higher to your half moon pose. Option one, stay here. Option two, candy cane pose, Shavasana, if you have it in practice. Bend the left knee, reach back with the left hand, grab the ankle and kick. Kick the heel away from the bum, open the chest. Hold it here, maybe look up to the ceiling or look down if you need to stabilize the balance. Hold it for one body breath. Now back to your half moon pose, straighten the left arm and the left leg. Soften the right knee, step back to your warrior two. Spread the arms out wide. One more time. Sit the hips down, lower. Now straighten the right leg. Turn the left toes up. Look towards the left foot. Squat to the back of the mat. Skandhasana. Palms to the heart center. Float the ball of the right foot off the mat. Sink the hips down low. Lifting the chest. Look towards the right foot this time. Now bend the right knee. Rise up to your warrior two. As you inhale, spread the arms apart. Sit down low with the exhale. Now Skandhasana. Bend the left knee. Palms to the heart center. Squat to the back. Pull up. Warrior two. Sit the hips down low. Exhale. Skandhasana, palms to the heart center, squat to the back. Pull back up, warrior two. One more time. Skandhasana, palms to the heart center. Now pause here, flex the right toes towards you. Push into the palms, option to stay here or split the arms apart. If you're splitting the arms apart, make sure the left tricep stays inside the left knee. You can go for a half bind, make sure you can back or full bind if you choose. Start to feel the inner thigh stretch and strengthen at the same time. As you lift the hips, try not to sit down. Roll the right shoulder back. So you can straighten the right arm and look up to the ceiling. For three. For two. And one. Gently release, palms to the heart center. Rise up to your warrior two. Bend the right knee, sink the hips down low. Hold it here. Now windmill the hands down. Kick the right leg up, three-legged dog. You can flow through any vinyasa that you like, three-legged vinyasa, normal vinyasa, or just come straight to your downward facing dog. Deep breath in. Full breath out. Feet together, heels up high, soften the knees, now look forward, step or hop forward. Top of the mat, half lift, lengthen the spine heel, exhale the fold. Inhale to rise, palms touch, lean back, arch back into your back bend. Exhale to bow, forward all the way down, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine heel, exhale to fold. Step the left leg back, lower the left knee down, low lunge. The other side, stretch arms up high. Look forward, sit the hips down low, inhale. As you exhale, twist to your left, right hand forward, left hand back, split the arms apart. Reverse left hand to the back leg, sweep right bicep by the ear, lean back, arch back, stay here. So you can bend the right knee more. Crawl the left fingertips down, closer to the left ankle, and stretch right hand back. Hold it here, reach back more. One more deep breath, inhale. As you exhale, place right hand inside the right foot. Inhale to sweep the left bicep by the ear, exhale to roll the left shoulder back. So you can lean back further. Hold it here, one more deep breath. Now back to low lunge, stretch your arms up high. Turn the palms to face forward, hook the thumbs together, switch your grip, spread the fingers out wide. Bicep break with the ears or bring it back this time and lean back. So your face should be in front of your arms. Your arms cannot be in front of the face. It's either bicep by the ears or behind the ears, try your best. Keep the chest lift, reach back more. One more deep breath, inhale. Now hands down, find your three-legged dog, kick the right leg up. Point the right toes up to the ceiling, deep breath, inhale. Knee to the right tricep, exhale, shift the weight forward to touch. Inhale, kick the right leg up, three-legged dog. Knee to the nose, exhale to touch. Inhale, kick the right leg up, three-legged dog. Knee to the left tricep to touch and hold, pull it up high. Extend the right leg out, spin the inner left foot down, stretch your left hand up, reverse side plank or your fallen triangle. Hold it here. Now see if we can sweep the left bicep by the ear, lean back further. And last option, plug the femur bone into the socket and float the right leg up as high as you can. Inner thigh strength. One more deep breath, inhale. Left hand down, kick the right leg up, bend the right knee, open the hips as you exhale. Straighten the right leg, inhale, downward facing dog, exhale. Plank, inhale. Your choice of vinyasa, chaturanga, or nishashin, exhale. Inhale to up dog or cobra. Exhale to press back, downward facing dog, one breath in. Full breath out. Feet together, heels up high, lap and stretch up, three-legged dog, inhale. Knee to the nose, exhale, shift the weight forward to touch. Circle the knee, open hips as inhale, stay or flip mouthing. Ball of the left foot behind you, left bicep body here. Chest up, maybe touch the left fingertips down. Arching the back, back bend, one more breath, inhale. Left hand down, kick the left leg up. Bend the left knee, open the hips as you exhale. Right heel up, high heel. Knee to the nose, exhale, shift the weight forward, touch and hold for 3, 2, 1. Crescent lunge, step the left foot between the hands slightly. Stretch your arms up high. Bend the left knee, sink the hips down low, now square the hips. Set up the crescent lunge properly, draw the outer left hip back. Hug the ribcage in, tuck the tailbone under, stretch your arms up. Back heel up high, just for one breath, inhale. Open up, warrior two, exhale. Split the arms apart, left hand forward, right hand back. Now look forward, lean towards left hand, flip the left palm heel, reverse warrior, exhale. Right hand to the back leg, sweep left bicep body here. Stretch back further. One more deep breath. Back to warrior two, inhale, supported side angle, exhale. Left elbow on top left thigh, sweep the right bicep body here, spin the right shoulder back. Now option to stay here on your forearms or place left finger pads inside the left foot. Continue to lean and roll the right shoulder back. Try not to rest the belly on the left thigh. So stay with the lift, lifting the chest towards the right and up towards the ceiling. One more deep breath. Back to your warrior two, inhale. Now straighten the right leg, the left leg, sorry. Walk the right foot forward, one step. Lean forward, left hand down, right hand reach up, Trikonasana, triangle pose. You can rest left hand on the shins or come up higher, make sure both legs are straight. You can also go down deeper and both legs can be straightened. Place left fingertips outside the left foot. But try not to collapse. So roll the left shoulder towards the right side and stretch your right hand up. Maybe adding on to deepen the twist by sweeping the right bicep out of here. Roll the right shoulder back slightly. Hold it here. For one more deep breath. Now place right hand on the right hip. Look down towards the left foot, slowly pull the left fingertips forward. And float the right leg up. Find the balance. If you need to stabilize, you can keep looking down to find the balance. Peel the right hip open with the right hand, right toes should be pointing towards the right side. Once you're ready, extend right hand up to the ceiling, find half moon pose. Option to stay here or candy cane pose. Your chapasana, bend right knee. Reach back with the right hand, grab the ankle from the outside and kick. Kick the heel away from the bum. Roll the right shoulder back. If you need to stabilize balance, look down again. Otherwise, you can gaze up to the ceiling. You're gonna stay here for 3, for 2, and 1. Slowly straighten the right leg. Find a half moon pose first. Then soften the left knee, step back. Spread the arms apart. Find your warrior two, sit the hips down low. Straighten the left leg. Now turn the right toes out, look towards the right foot, Skandasana, squat your back. Palms to the heart center, now foot the ball of the left foot off the mat. Set up it properly, your Skandasana first. So inner thigh strength, push the right tricep into right knee, lift the chest to the thumbs. Now 3 times, pull yourself up. Warrior two, spread the arms apart. Bend right knee, Skandasana, squat to the back. Inhale to pull up, warrior two, spread the arms apart, sit the hips down low. Skandasana, sit back, bend the right knee, squat to the back. One more time, inhale, rise up, warrior two, sit the hips down low. Exhale to your Skandasana, bend the right knee, push tricep into the right knee, lift the chest, option to stay here or split the arms. Right hand down, left hand reach up. You can opt for half bind, reach left hand back, grab the inner right thigh, or full bind if you choose. If you're in full bind, try to reach for the left wrist if you can. So you can pull, lifting the chest straight and the arms. Maybe eventually, one day, touch left fingertips down to the mat. Flex the left foot. Look up to the ceiling, neck long. One more deep breath here. Release back to your Skandasana, palms to our center, look to the left foot, pull up to your warrior two. Spread arms apart, sit hips down low. Windmill the handstand, kick the left leg up to your three-legged dog. Option to flow through three-legged vinyasa, normal vinyasa, or just simply step back to your downward facing dog. Your all medium down dog. Together, take one deep breath in. Full breath out. Feet together, heels up high. Now soften the knees, look forward. Step or hop outside the hands, come to your malasana. Squat down all the way, palms to the heart center. Now push the knees apart. Not gonna stay too long from here. Roll the shoulders back, chest lift, one more deep breath. Now stay here and reach your arms up high. Keep the chest lifted, keep the heels grounded. Tuck the tailbone under, chest forward, one more deep breath, kneel. Exhale, hands down, straighten the legs. Keep the feet mat distance apart, fold between the thighs. Inhale to rise, palm stretch, lean back, arch back to your back bend. Exhale to bow forward all the way down, Uttanasana, forward fold. Half lift, lengthen the spine heel. Exhale to fold, now step or hop back, flow to your last vinyasa. And let's all meet in your downward facing dog. Stay here in down dog, deep breath in. Exhale, three. Inhale. Exhale, two. One more deep breath in. Full breath out. Lower the knees down. Come to your child's pose. Sit the hips back, stretch your arms forward, lower the forehead down. Hold it here. One more deep breath. Slowly rise all the way up. That was our yin part for this part for this class. So let's start the yin class. So the yin part, I'll be coming closer towards you. Right, so if you have a block, you can grab the block. If you do not have a block, it doesn't matter, I'll give you options. Right. Let's find your Baddha, your butterfly pose. So place your feet soles closer together when you're in a seated position on the sit bone. So you can drag the heels closer towards the groin. Now if this is too challenging for you, if it's too hot, inner thighs are not too open, hips are not too open, you can slide the feet away from you for a start. Otherwise, pull it close to you. If you can even go deeper, you can place a block between your feet. Then press it down. You might find the knees more elevated from the ground, but it doesn't matter. We want to slowly open the inner thighs. So your option, different levels, different practice, it doesn't matter. Listen to your own body. Notice how you feel today and pick the option that suits you best, all right? We're going to stay in this pose for three minutes. So we can always deepen the pose later part towards the end of the 3 minutes. So start with where you're comfortable with first. You can choose a block, without the block, just a simple Baddha Konasana. Now chest lift, instead of rounding the back. A lot of us, we tend to round the back and a lot of pressure in the lower back. So keep the chest lifted. Lengthen the spine, roll the shoulders back. Option one, you can stay here. Option two, if you like, you can pull softly and fold forward. Or maybe just release the hands down to the ground. So for yin class, we try not to force. We allow gravity to help us to deepen the pose. So set it up properly. Once already, let's begin 3 minutes from now. If you'd like to close your eyes, you can go ahead. Otherwise, you can keep your eyes open, but just keep a soft gaze. Think of melting the chest down towards the ground. Towards your feet. So try not to force here, even if your pulling is a very light pull. For me, I prefer to just place the hands down to the mat. So for yin class, I try to allow gravity to do its work instead of me trying to impose and pull, but it doesn't matter, it's your own practice. Just make sure you're not hurting yourself.
Stay focused on the breath. It doesn't matter how you look like right now. So remember, yoga is not about the poses. Yes, poses are part of yoga, but it's just a small part. Eventually, we want to work towards inner peace, creating space within the body. So my question, how do all these poses help me to get there? The idea is, a lot of times, the poses make us uncomfortable, physically or mentally. Physically, because it might be tough, the body is not open. Mentally, it might be because you want to attain it faster than you like it to be. You want to attain some poses. You feel anxious, you feel frustrated. So the idea is to work through all this discomfort. We can allow space to embrace all this discomfort. Finding the inner peace, that makes so much more meaning and sense to yoga. As I talk, time passes. We're halfway through, so see if you want to deepen the pose. If you like to deepen the pose, you can always have a few options. You can drag the heels closer towards you if you're seated up. Or if you're folding forward, so you can fold deeper, maybe crawl the fingertips forward a little bit more. Now instead of dropping the head down, you want to look forward. Because you want to keep the spine lengthened, just a slight forward. Try not to strain the neck, so you don't need to look up. Just look forward slightly. Now see whether you can softly press the soles of the feet into the block or press the soles of the feet together. And maybe gently press the knees down towards the mat. Notice how your inner thighs, your hips are feeling right now. Embrace the discomfort. That is how we train to find stillness and breathing through the discomfort. Left just 20 seconds ago. Slowly, so that we don't injure ourselves. Stretch your legs forward and pat it up. Alright, now your inner thighs and the hips are more open. Let's shred the feet apart. Find your middle splits. Sit the hips down to the ground. Alright, find the middle splits. Spread the feet out wide. If you have something soft, you want to make yourself comfortable, you can go ahead and place it in front of you. We're going to stretch forward. If you like, if it gives you more comfort, you can do that, all right? Otherwise, shred the feet as wide as you can. I'm gonna sit back a little bit more so you can see me clearly. Stretch your feet out wide, flex the feet. Now, see if you can sit the bum forward a little bit more, squeeze slightly on top of the kneecap tight, and roll the toes back. Then relax the toes one more time. So option to stay here, this is already too much for you for a start, you can stay here first. Otherwise, if you like to go forward, you can always crawl forward. If you like to place something soft on the belly, you can go ahead, you can lower the forearms down. If you can go all the way down, instead of looking to the belly button and place your forehead down to the mat, I would advise you to look forward again. So you can touch your chin down to the mat. Set it up properly, relax the toes. So this is in class, try not to flex the toes for now. So just relax. Slowly opening the inner thighs and the hips. And now 3 minutes begin from now. Again, same thing. If you like to close your eyes, you can go ahead. Now be very careful whenever in yin class, we want to go to the deeper straight away. So try not to do that. Go to a point where the body feels a stretch, a nice good stretch. So notice whether there's any pain. Good pain is good. Good pain means you're not pushing too hard. You're stretching it out. You can feel the tension, but you don't injure the body. If you can lower all the way down, touching the chest down to the mat, you can go ahead. Close your eyes if you like. Now we talked about discomfort earlier. As we hold here, creating space for the discomfort, whatever that means to you, you can be breathing deeply to create space. And see whether you're fighting that. Are you resisting that discomfort? Most of us do, it's a very natural instinct. We try to resist, we try to fight what we don't like. And see if you can work a way around it, softening the body. Just slowly allowing the discomfort to be there, not fighting it. And see how you can take the same concept to work mentally. How you can soften your thoughts around this. Telling yourself there's no need to distract yourself from it. There's no need to fight it. Think about you trying to make friends with it. Make friend with this pose. Right, half the time gone. See if you can lower down a bit more. Maybe bring something fluffy and comforting on towards your chin. So you can fall a bit deeper, maybe stretch your arms forward. Again, notice whether there's any pain, only good pain. And see if you can allow this good pain to make you go deeper. I focus on this a lot of times in yin yang class or in yin classes. So deeper doesn't mean you go to the maximum. Deeper can just mean you learn to breathe deeper in your pose. 1 more minute to go. Another 30 seconds to explore what is depth to you in this pose. Sometimes depth can also mean backing off a little bit more, working on your breath. Last 10 seconds to go. Slowly walk the hands back first. It's very important to come out of it carefully. Make sure the sit bone stays grounded to the mat first. Now slowly, hands on the knees. Instead of sliding the knees towards you, see if you can bring the feet forward a little bit first. Just forward a little bit. And bring it forward a little bit more. Close it together. Then shake it out, bend the knees. How's everyone doing? Okay? Alright, we're going to counter stretch a little bit. So we stretch out the inner thighs, we open the hips a little bit more. It's important to balance it up. So we're going to balance it up by coming to a half fixed firm pose. So half fixed firm, half your pose. I'm going to show you what I'm going to do. If you have a block, I'm going to elevate a little bit because we're going to lean back, alright? So you're going to come forward, alright? So stretch both feet forward, alright? Both legs straight forward. Then start to sit towards the right side, the right bum, and bend the right knee. Bring the heel closer towards the bum. And sit the left hip down. Now if the left hip comes up, it doesn't matter. You can always sit on the block if this is too hard for you. If the left bum is like this, if it's too tight, you cannot sit on the ground, then sit on the block. Or maybe find a fluffy thing to sit on, all right? If you have another thing that you can lie on, even better. Okay, so I'm going to set this up first. So press, make sure the toes are pointing to the back. Toes are not pointing towards the left side, it's pointing to the back here. Keep the right leg relaxed and straight. If something fluffy or block, I want you to place it at the back, on the lower back. You can keep it straight if you want to just massage the back, otherwise keep on the, stay here if you can come to a lower part of the block, alright? Place it back down and lie back. Maybe come to the forearm. If you can lie all the way down, go ahead. Otherwise, if this is too hard for you, you can always stay seated like this. And then go down a little bit further. You want some comfort, place your fluffy thing, your poster or whatever behind you. And slowly, gently lie down. Once you're all the way down, you can reach the arms by the side. I'll be giving you options later to deepen this pose, but I'd like you to stay in this pose first for 3 minutes. And your 3 minutes begin now. So stay where you are, I'm just coming over to check on you. No, the toes, because I saw this comment, alright. So the toes are not okay to go forward. Try to point it back. So if it comes, because we don't want to hurt the ankles, we want the toes to point back, alright? So try to see if you can point it back. If it is hard for you, then you might want to elevate yourself. You can always sit onto something, alright? If the ankles on the knees are hurting, you can bring, they can have a small gap between both knees. Otherwise, keep them together. Now again, learn to breathe into this pose. The left hip will tend to always want to come off the mat. So see what I can, just don't need to force, just roll towards the left side a little bit. One minute has passed. Notice how the body feels right now. Again, and see how it can deepen the pose again. With the concept in mind that you don't need to do so. But if you feel good, you can do that. Deepening the pose can mean a few things. Again, breathing deeply. Perhaps bring the knees closer together. Or even removing the something from underneath, you can lie down all the way back down to your mat. But be very careful with this. Time flies, 1 more minute to go. Last 20 seconds. Now I want you to stay here in this pose. Option one, stay here and see whether you can bend the right knee. Step the right foot to the mat. If this is challenging for you, you can stay there. Now if you're all the way upright, You can also try to lean back. So for you, all the way upright, try to lean back and see if you can lower the forearms down. If not, just stay seated again and stay for another 1 minute. If you can bend the right knee, step the right foot and see if you can bend the right knee to the chest, lift the right foot off the mat. Interlace fingers below the right knee and pull it in. Now this might be challenging for a lot of us. Keep body down low and pull it in. We're not going to stay here for long. Just 1 minute. So you should feel a little bit more on the left thigh and the quad. Make sure the left knee stays on the ground. If the lifts off the ground, it is more important to just release the pose. Try not to force it again one more time. You should feel a very good left quad stretch. And press left hip down towards the left side a little bit more, walking inwards towards the IT bend as well. At the same time, we give the ankle a good stretch, opening the front of the ankle so the toes are pointing back. Last 25 seconds ago. Last 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Now if you're grabbing onto the knees, slowly press the feet down to mat first. If you're lying down, be very careful. Straighten the right leg. Then use the forearm, push and lift yourself halfway up first. Wipe right palm down, left palm down, sit all the way up first. Then roll the weight towards the right side of the hips. Slowly slide the left foot away towards the left side and bring it forward. How's everyone doing? Okay? Now, bend the knee, shake it up, the other side to go. Same thing, let's set it up properly before we start counting. So bend the right knee, bring the heel closer towards the right hip. Do not sit on the heel. Point the toes back, the top of the right foot stays on the ground. If this is challenging for you, you can always stay elevated, sit on the block or sit on the pillow or something, bring it up, bring your bum up a little bit higher. Now option one, stay here if this is already too much for you or you know your option, you can lie down to the back. If you want to add in a little bit of lower back massage, you can use a block, otherwise use a pillow or something soft, lie down all the way. And if you can go even deeper, release the pillow and the 3 minutes starts now. Continue to press the right knee down to the mat. Again, if you have any knees issues, you can always slide the knees apart. Otherwise, you can bring it closer together. Do not lift the right knee off the mat. If there's a lot of pain, a lot of tension, you back it off by bringing the right knee upwards slightly. So in the hero pose, this is our half hero pose. Be very careful on the knees. Sometimes you get impatient, you want to just lie down straight. So listen to the body step by step. Notice where your right hip is right now, so you can press right hip down to the mat a little bit. Any variation of the arms you like. 1 minute has passed. Stay connected with the breath. Try not to fight it. You feel something in the right leg. IT bend. The right ankle. Quads. one last minute? Last 10. Now stay where you are, slowly, same thing, bend left. If you are seated up, try the lower back into your forearms, maybe, if not just the upper. Now step the left foot to the mat if you're all the way down. And see if you can lift the left foot off the mat. Interlace the fingers below the left knee. Now make sure the right knee stays grounded. If the right knee lifts off the mat, it's better off not to float the left foot off the mat. So if you feel more intensity to stretch out the right knee, the right quads. Your 1 minute begins now. Not really to pull the left knee closer towards the chest. Yes, we want to make our way towards that, but the focus is more on the right leg. So just hold on to the left knee. Working deeper into your breath. If the hips roll to the left, press down softly to the right, roll to the right a little bit more. Last 10. Slowly press yourself up. Sit the weight towards the left side. Stretch your right leg forward. Pat it out. How's everyone doing? Okay? Alright. Just simply lie down on your mat. If you like a spinal twist, you can drop the knees to the left or the right. And eventually find your Shavasana. So if you like a spinal twist, you can drop the knees to the right or left or just massage your back. Eventually, make your way to your final Shavasana. If you wish to stay longer in the final Shavasana, you can go ahead. Otherwise, I'm coming over to just connect to you before we end the class. How's everyone doing? Okay? I hope you enjoy the practice. We open the inner thighs and the hips, and then after that, we counter that with another the stretches, which is a close hip stretch. So stretch out the IT band and the outer part of the legs as well. I hope your legs are more open by now. Alright, thank you so much for joining me, everyone. Thank you, Patty. Thank you, Stacy, Michelle. Thank you so much. Thank you, Christy. Alright, I only have 30 seconds to kind of close off with you. If you have any question, feedback, comments, you can always write into Pure Yoga Singapore. If you'd like to just drop me a message, you can also drop me a message on my personal IG account, which is just below. Otherwise, I will see you again. Have a happy Monday. Thank you so much, everyone. Only 10 seconds remaining for this video. So I wish you a happy Monday ahead, and then I'll see you again maybe on Saturday. See you again. Bye.